Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel, Lumen Moon Tarot. So, Divine Feminine, Divine Masculine, this is your Twin Flame Soulmate update today, and it's going to be different and interesting, okay? Just stick with me on this. So anyway, guys, let me get through my spiel, because this is going to be a different one, alright? I can't shake the message. I can't shake it. So I have to spread it, okay? I can't shake the message. I have to spread the message before it can be lifted off of me, all right? This reading is for the collective, my darlings. It's not going to resonate with everyone. If it doesn't resonate with you, it's okay. Don't panic. It just means that this isn't your story, that's all. But I feel like this reading is going to resonate with the Divine Feminines for sure. And if it does and you like this video, please go ahead, give me a fat thumbs up, okay? Subscribe to the channel, help me grow. We're helping everybody here grow. And if you would like to make a donation, there's a link to follow at the bottom of the description box. And this channel is for adults only. They won't let me get it out of my head. There is a song that has been playing in my head all day, and I can't, they won't let me leave it alone. As a matter of fact, I forgot to look up a definition too, because they're making me do all of this for you. I did a Cancer reading earlier today, and for those of you who aren't Cancers, it's okay. Just wait. It's coinciding with the Divine Feminines, all right? I had, even in Cancer, the Cancer read, I was calling out the Divine Feminines in that read, because this reading, I feel they want me to get a message out about those who are inspiring, and AKA, you guys, I feel, are muses, all right? Hold on a second. I just want to look up the definition, because a muse to me is somebody who is very inspiring, and there were 9 muses in Greek mythology. We're going to get to that, and they all were inspiring in different categories, okay? Definition of a muse. Okay, each of 9 goddesses, yeah, the daughter of Zeus, a person or personified force who is the source of inspiration for a creative artist. Okay, let me reread that. A person or personified force. Personified force, Divine Feminine. Okay, who is the source of inspiration for a creative artist. Okay, so that is the dictionary definition of a muse, all right? All right, so here's the deal. The song that's been playing in my head is The Fall by ELO, okay? It was all over the last Cancer reading. Even if you're not a Cancer, you may want to check it out because it's the same message for the Divine Feminine. So anyway, in the song The Fall, I gotta try to remember the words. There's a movie called Xanadu. I don't know how old you guys are, but I'm getting up there, okay? Anyway, in Xanadu, it's about one of the muses, and I think it's the muse of dance. It's gotta be the muse of dance. And because it's kind of a musical. And I think that one was Terpsichore. Is that her name? Terpsichore? Terpsichore? I know it's a weird name, but I'm thinking it was either Talia or Terpsichore. I'm pretty sure it was Terpsichore. Anyway, in the movie, all of the 9 muses are sent down to Earth, okay? They're on a mission. Right? That's hint number 1. On a mission. All right? 9 of them. That's hint number 2. They were the daughters of Zeus. Zeus had 9 daughters, and they were all muses, only they had different categories. The one, I believe, of dance, it's got to be dance, was sent down and into the movie Xanadu, okay? With Olivia Newton-John. Great movie. Anyway, the reason why it led me to Xanadu is because they won't stop playing the song The Fall by ELO in my head. And the part that they're playing is, our love couldn't go wrong. How could I know? I was only dreaming. And now that you're gone, I will go on really believing. I take the fall, right? Okay, so that's how the song goes in the movie. And in the movie, when they're playing that song, there's a scene where the guy, he fell in love with the muse, okay? He fell in love with her. She inspired him to start a whole new way of life, okay? My fingers are tingling. Yeah, I'm on the right track. This muse inspired him, to change his life. Okay, and go after his dreams, you know? He was holding himself back and being around people that just kept him under their thumb. And she inspired him to reach for something bigger. And in the process, he fell in love with her, okay? That was her mission, okay? That was her mission to do. She was on mission work, divine feminine, okay? And that's just your nature. Divine Feminine is to inspire others just with your high vibes and your happiness and your loving, caring, nurturing, honest nature, okay? It's lovely and it's charming. And you do plant seeds. She plants these little seeds throughout the whole movie. The biggest one was the name of Xanadu. She planted a seed just by saying something poetic, okay? And that's my son playing video games in the back. I guarantee you, I'm not skinning him. I'm nowhere near him, okay? It's him having fun. Anyway, she inspires people, and then it's done. It's time. Her mission is over, and it's time for her to move forward, okay? And he fell in love with her. Now, in the scene, in the movie, during that song, he's roller skating around, okay, through the song, and he's looking at the mural of the 9 sisters, the 9 muses on a brick wall. And he just wants his muse back. Do you see where I'm going here? The guy just wants his muse back, okay? She's a divine feminine. She is. She's Zeus's daughter. She's high vibing. She's here on a mission. She's here to inspire the world, okay? And create a ripple of high-vibing energy. What does that sound like to you? This is where I'm going. This is why they won't let me stop. Okay, so anyway, she goes back to Zeus, and his only outlet, his only idea to find her again, because she tells him about this. Your masculine knows now about this journey. Make no bones about it, your masculine knows. So he knows who she is because she told him. And then she proved it to him. So he saw it with his own eyes. She can prove it. And then she was gone. Her mission work was gone. She took off. So you're gone, okay? And the guy is standing there. The masculine is standing there, and he decides, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna take this fall. And he decides to skate directly into that brick wall with her painting on it. Directly into the brick wall at full speed, face first, okay? To try to get to her, and he does. He does. He goes to the other plane, right, where Zeus is, and they have a little talky talk, right? I'm not going to give the movie away, and it's a fabulous movie, but the song in it, our love couldn't go wrong. How could I know? I was only dreaming. And now that you're gone, I will go on really believing. I take the fall. Do 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 do. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, that's where this is going. Another thing that I found out was when I did the adding of everything together. So there's 9 muses, right? And really, technically, they're divine beings too, right? For Greek mythology, anyways. And, you know, you have to kind of separate the two stories, but they're so dang similar, and they won't let me forget about it. So anyway, there's 9 muses in Greek mythology that really are very powerful manifestors, and they're here to inspire and raise vibrations, okay? By planting seeds and allowing others to make their own decisions with them. What does that sound like to you, Divine Feminine, okay? And then there's 144,000 divine beings right here now. So there's 144,000 twin flames, okay? 144,000. That's what makes up all of the twin flames. Once you break down 144,000, it breaks down into what? The number 9. Yeah. So there's just so many. It's not even a coincidence. There's synchronicities here. Do you know what I mean? And they won't let me let it go. You Divine Feminine, you're just inspiring the world right now with your high vibes. All right? You're working on yourself. Most of all, you're inspiring your person. You're inspiring your person. They're realizing it, but what's holding your person back is their pride and ego still. It's the only thing coming in between having this understanding in this divine journey and connection to having a new start. It's the only thing coming in between you is their pride and their ego, okay? Because see, maybe at first they didn't believe, but now they can see that you're proving them wrong just by focusing on you, loving yourself, and going through your spiritual transformation and the work you've done on yourself. And look at, you're about to step into wealth. Your dreams are coming true here, and people are watching and wondering, oh my gosh, how is she doing it? And being inspired by you at the same time. Like, wow, you're absolutely amazing. And I feel like your person is in awe, fully regretting. Look at this, fully regretting letting you go and choosing the wrong option here. They treated you like an option in the first place. You don't do that to a divine feminine. But I don't think your person realized it anymore, you know. Our love couldn't go wrong. Think about it. Our love couldn't go wrong because it was divine. And divinely ordained, okay? A divine connection. Our love couldn't go wrong. How could I know? I was only dreaming. They didn't believe. They were only dreaming about wherever they were going, you know, or thought they were going in their own life, whoever it was that they chose over you. And now that you're gone, I will go on really believing, right? Because they can see the transformation in your own life. And everything that you're saying or have been saying or have told them in the past, everything you've proven, you've shown them the changes and how powerful in your own life, okay, that this connection really is. And now they want to come. Well, here's the wheels. The guy in the movie was roller skating. They want to roller skate right in to get you, okay, as fast as they can. I take the fall. And they don't want anyone else to take you. They don't want anyone else. They don't want you with anybody else. They want to bowl over all of the competition here. But the one thing that's standing in this person's way is their ego here. One person, that the only thing that's standing in their way is their ego. Because they didn't believe, and now they've chose someone else. They know they have to make things better with you. They know that you were the soulmate connection here that they wanted. You know that this, they know that this was a gift from the divine. You are the muse. When this muse card came out during your reading, I just about crap my pants. I am not kidding, because all I've been hearing today in messages from the divine are things, you know, channeled messages, are things about muses. That's it. And Greek mythology, and this movie about the muse, and the song about the, I mean, it's just the song about the connection and where it's going and everything. And then I shuffled the cards and this flew out. Seriously. I thought I was going to crap myself. So, you know, and it says muse right here. I don't know if you can see it. Muse. Oh, gosh. I've totally forgot. It's a really old movie. That's why. Oh, in the movie, the guy is a painter. Freaking A, man. This is driving me crazy today. I seriously woke up like this, okay? I woke up like this. And it hasn't let me go. So I know I'm on the right track here, and I have to get it out. Otherwise, they won't let me stop thinking about it. So yeah, your person didn't realize who you are, but you did something to this person, Divine Feminine. You did something to your masculine. I don't know what you did or what you said, but you planted some kind of seed. You planted a seed in this person's mind somehow to do better and live better and take a look at themselves. And they have. And they're so regretful. This is a person who put you in a third-party situation, like I said, and turned their back on you. Right? Their third-party situation is getting all dumped out. And your person now has gone within, you know. And now that you're gone, I will go on really believing. They're figuring this out, that everything you said, everything you're showing them is real. About the connection, about the whole divine prophecy, about the 144,000, about all of it. They're realizing that it was real, and they were fooling themselves. They're realizing that, you know, this was something big and very hard to sink their teeth into, but this was the only thing really that was true. Everything else that they invested in was false. And the one that had them believing in something bigger, something magical, that was real? That's what this person is like, what? Instantly holding on to their pride and ego there, okay? Because knowing how they treated you as a divine feminine, I think they're crapping themselves. I think they're sitting here crapping. There's a little dookie in those drawers, I'm telling you, because they know now how magic, this is magic. And I don't want to say magic, like, don't think bad magic, like it's just magic, it's magical, like Drew Barrymore, you know, magical. Yeah. It's something that they didn't think they could believe until now. And now they, you know, and now that you're gone, I will go on really believing. 'Cause they lost their muse. They lost their muse. And now they want to skate into a brick wall to get you back, okay. Divine Feminine. How am I doing here, Divine? Am I doing okay? Because, you know, I really want them to not. I want to switch to different messages, because this one has been going on in my head since 7:30 this morning. Okay? So anyway, yeah, look it up. It's a song called The Fall by ELO and the movie Xanadu. Those are the things that had just those little clips, you know, and fabulous, fabulous all around. They're great, great song and movie. Everything is great. But I just want to I want to get the messages out to you, okay? And then, yeah, kind of clear my energy of it. But yeah, your person, they're so regretful. They're suffering. They know the loss that they're suffering now because you know what? There's not that many of you. There's not that many of you. And this kind of magical thing here, this kind, your kind of soul magical whatever, your mojo, your energy, they're not going to find it. It's a rarity. It really is. And your person's realizing that. That's just a huge hit to the gut. You know? And here, even though they lost you, you know, let's just say there's... And honestly, I can't say if they lost you or not. Personally, if this is a divine connection, if it's meant to be, it's going to come together no matter what. Because you can't... If it's meant to be, it's meant to be, it's meant to be, man, okay? So I can't tell that. That's for the divine to put judgment on, not me. But, you know, if they have lost you, this person knows they're never going to find another muse. Muses, there's in Greek mythology, there's only 9. And in divine feminines, there's only 144,000 twin flames. Both are a rarity. Both are magical. Both are real. And, you know, I mean, you're a muse. Whether you want to believe it or not, divine feminine, you're a muse. You have a calling here on earth to inspire others, raise vibrations, and, you know, plant seeds to help other people have a happier life, I guess, and follow their dreams, you know? To be happy and keep your vibes high, it's a beautiful thing, and this person knows they're never gonna find it again. They're not going to be able to find another you, Divine Feminine. They're not going to be able to find another you. So, you know, it's... But yet at the same time, they poo-pooed everything, maybe. They didn't believe. They could have made fun of the things that you talk about or your spiritual journey. They could have done anything. They could have really put you down. And now... You're the only thing that they wish they had again. Where is my muse? And now that you're gone, you know, and now that you're gone, I will go on really believing. Because now they can see the changes you've made in your own life, and they know it's real now. They know you're telling the truth. They know you're telling the truth. And they're like, oh, what have I done? There they go crapping themselves, you know? Because they understand the giant scope of this. But they're still in their pride and ego right now, too much to have this fresh start. You know, that's the only thing standing in between of this understanding and a fresh start is their ego and pride. But I think that's breaking too. Because look, they finally pick you up here. The one that they left alone for so long, you wilted. And they're crying over you now. That pride and ego is about to crack. I'm telling you. It's fallen apart. Their pride and ego is fallen apart because you're just too powerful in this person's mind and heart now that they know the truth. You know? They know it. Deep down within, they know it. And I think you know it too. I think you're both using your intuition on this, and I really feel like your person is going to either like they're sitting there typing a text message, you know, and then hitting delete over and over and over again, or they may even be thinking about writing you a letter. But I know this weekend they're very emotional. It's hitting them. And they need to get past this. They need to get past this pride and ego thing. It's okay to be wrong, you know? The big question is, can they handle things right? Have they done enough work on themselves? Have they looked at everything about their patterns? Are they willing to live a better life and go after what they want? You know? I think people are watching you too, Divine Feminine, like come up, basically. Yeah, I feel like this journey, this twin flame journey has brought you a lot of abundance here, and you're at the end of the cycle now. You're wealthy, but look at their success is upside down. And I feel like that's one of the reasons why they're watching you like in awe. In awe. Because I think that, you know, they've got no success in anything right now. But look at you. This is you. Beautiful, successful, maybe even on your way to being wealthy. If you aren't already. Opportunities coming your way, luck, people noticing you, people. Look at this person here is in awe of you too. There we go. Sorry about that, people. My battery died. All right, so let's move these things. But yeah, they're not successful in much, but you're extremely successful at the end of this cycle here, and very abundant. You earned this, though. You worked for this, and you're fabulous and beautiful and everything. And like they're like, kapow, how is this person doing? Look at though. They're like, wow. You know, some of them are trying to figure you out. I see their brows like, how does she do it? Yeah, they could be both actually feeling both those ways, your person. But let's move some of these. I'll leave the Muse cards out for sure, because I'm really seeing a huge synchronicity there. You know what I mean? Too much for me to ignore in a reading. And I'm here to be your messenger, so I'm doing what I gotta do. I hope I don't think I said anything that should offend anyone, though. All right. What else can you show us, Divine? Yeah, once again, your person feels like they've missed an opportunity here. This is a gift from the divine. Now they know it. There you go, another synchronicity. They know you were a gift. That means your person knows that you were telling the truth the whole time, being totally real about this the whole time. And now they're like, frick, they were right. This is divine. Because you're showing them. You're showing them, and at the same time, you're inspiring them. The Muse thing, the crap. They keep showing me that scene. And it's like haunting music. Like, I don't know all the words. I'm just picking up like little bits, but it's very like eerie music. I wish I knew the whole song. Something about it's a lie. It's a lie. Because they didn't believe you. They didn't believe you. Our love couldn't go wrong. How could I know? I was only dreaming. Yeah. And now that you're gone, they want you back. Now that you're gone, I will go on really believing, because they know exactly who you are. They want you back. They want to build something solid here. This is reuniting, celebrating happy times, you know? They want this back, Divine Feminine. They're tired of being out in the cold. They could be, like I said, very low on their pentacles, though. Just be aware of that. But that has nothing to do, I don't think, with how much they regret not believing you about this journey. For those of you who have said something to your partner, or, I don't know, they heard it. I know they've been studying you. They could have picked up on it along the way. I think there's a lot of masculines out there, too, who have been studying this themselves. It's been very hard for them to believe, but now they believe it. Options for you. Your person could actually be walking away here. I feel like they walked away because they did have other options, number one. Now they could be walking away because you have other options, because this landed on you with the people who are looking at you. They may think you have other options. They may want to walk away from this. They may even feel like they definitely will miss this opportunity because they have already turned their back on it, and muses don't come around every day. It's, you know, you find one maybe once in a lifetime, maybe. They're going through the dark night of the soul, realizing that. Knowing that it could have been a happy home, but there were too many women in the picture here. They could have been happy. Our love couldn't go wrong. How could I know? I was only dreaming. I feel like they left you for someone else. And now they know, you know what? Your love couldn't go wrong. Yeah. Feel like you're moving on from this. I feel like this is you. You've put down your burdens and you're moving to calmer waters. I think you made your decision to do that finally, like your final decision, I mean, your final decision to move forward with your life around this last full moon phase. For a lot of you, that was a very powerful moon phase. You know? And I think you got kind of a push from the divine to go there. Remember, you know, you are highly connected to the divine. So, what else can you show me here? But yeah, this is a rarity. It's not like they're going to find a divine feminine or a muse just walking around all over. Then, you know, they go to a mall and pick one up. No. It's not like that. Yeah. I feel like there's still so many things kept hidden here. I feel like this is your person. You could be dealing with a Cancer. You could even be a Cancer. You're going to calmer waters, especially if you're a Cancer. You're moving on. You've already put your burdens down and moved on. Or you're at least attempting to here. You're leaving the scene now. Let's put it that way. Right about now, you're getting in that boat and shoving off, okay? Because this person made you wait too long and had you feeling like an option. If you're not a Cancer, or your person isn't a Cancer, you know, this is like things being, your person doesn't have all the answers yet. I think the more they find out, the more they'll drop their ego. I think there's things about this that maybe they don't realize, that they're not going to find another you. I don't know. But there could be things that they're keeping hidden on purpose, or secrets, you know. But I think things are about to come out into the light. I really do. And I think this wheel, this mechanism here, I think that's going to start turning as well. Yeah, some things are being, yeah, things are gonna start turning. There's that wheel. What did I say? I just said it, man. Things about that wheel are gonna start turning as well, and here we get the Wheel of Fortune. It's gonna start happening. Things are gonna start moving forward because they have to moving forward. What did I say? Things are gonna start moving forward because they have to. This is someone coming to talk to you, perhaps. I feel like your masculine's coming. I feel like they want a victory in this. And maybe there's other people that know their situation too, and they're like supporting them in coming towards you. I feel that could be the thing that you don't know, is that they really do want a victory in this and they're coming. But their ego, yeah, because they can't stop thinking about you. They remember how you loved them. You know, and look, you gave them all this love kind of from a distance. You just sort of were there to nurture them and be kind and caring and give them love and inspire them. You let this person make their own decisions in their life and do whatever, you know, have their own life. But you were there to inspire them, and they're inspired now. And they can't stop watching you, I feel. Because they can't stop thinking about you and remembering how loving you were. You know, you gave your love freely to this person whenever they needed it. You really were there for them. With all that beautiful, unconditional love. You know? You could have known them for a very long time. There could be children involved in this as well. But this is them being very nostalgic this weekend. Yeah, they've gotten some clarity in the situation. They know exactly who you are. They know how powerful you are. They know, you know, that you're a divine being, divine feminine. And it's tearing them apart. Dark night of the soul. This is where your person is, really, this weekend. Dark night of the soul. Trying to tackle this pride and ego so they can come and get their, you know, crash through a brick wall to get their muse back. That's what I got. All right, let's get just a couple more for like a possible, so we have here. Ooh, that's too many, but yeah. You're in your Princess of Swords, the activist. You're going to defend yourself. You're going to defend your beliefs. You're going to stand up for what you believe in. You're going to hold on strong to your boundaries. Yeah, and you don't mind speaking either. If they want to come and talk to you, you don't have a problem talking. And you're going to choose your words very properly and speak loud and clear. Yeah, I think they're kind of worried about that. What's the possible outcome? That was too many, though. What's the possible outcome for this? Possible outcome. This deck is really slippery and really huge, guys, so I always have a hard time shuffling. The gourmet chef. They're cooking something up. This is somebody who's moving really slow. You know it. These steaks are slow cooked and homemade mashed potatoes. You know, the gourmet chef, they take a while to make, to prepare this, right? Your person is preparing to come to you and offer you some kind of stability here. I feel like they want to communicate. I feel like they want to try to fix this. Okay? Because they know how important the connection is. It's just that this is like the Knight of Pentacles. They're the slowest moving knight in the deck. So it's taken them a long time, but this is the most reliable. They're going to actually get there. Yeah, your person's been in a crossroads, not a crossroads, but stalemate. You guys haven't been talking, and they have been in the middle of trying to make a decision and speaking their truth. They need to spit. Here's two swords here. Twos to me mean choose, right? They have a choice to make. They have to speak their truth, I think, on both counts, with whoever it is that they've been with and with you. They need to do something here in order to have this peace. In order to have peace of mind, they need to speak up and speak their mind. That's kind of what I'm doing here. In order for me to have peace of mind, I have to get this message out. I was just talking about that. In order to have peace of mind, they need to speak their mind. All right, one more card. Possible outcome, please. Yeah, they're preparing though. I feel like this is preparing, yeah, to do the right thing. They're getting messages, signs and synchronicities by the divine. And I feel like right now they're preparing, and at the same time, they're putting a lot of thought into this, as to how to come around you the correct way. Okay, the correct way. But they know they have to do the right thing. They are fully aware, I think, that this is a divine soulmate connection. They're fully aware that you have these beautiful abilities. They're understanding this. They really are. But in order to come in a little quicker, they got to drop all of this pride and ego, man. They got to drop it. Yep. All right, everyone, that's what I got for you today. Look, if it didn't resonate with you, it's okay. It just wasn't for you, you know? But if it did resonate with you and you like this video, please go ahead and give me a big fat thumbs up. Like, subscribe, comment, share these videos. You guys are fabulous, and thank you so much for your support. Until next time, everyone, take care of you and peace out.